Hello and welcome to Talking on Purpose with Tori. This is the internet show where we talk about all things related to church growth, communication, and of course, media. I am Tori, a life coach and media ministry consultant living here in the Commonwealth of Virginia. Welcome. Welcome to this new trajectory of what I'm calling God awesomeness. If you're watching this via YouTube, please don't forget to click that subscribe button and the bell. And if you are already subscribed, thank you so much. Over the last 2 years, I have specifically worked with churches and faith-driven organizations to strengthen their online presence, improve communication with staff and volunteers, and create systems designed to combat inertia. I will share tips, give advice, and prayerfully get to know each of you as we walk faithfully with our Lord. Quick recap. Last week, I shared the carpenter story as a way of easing into the character traits and going the extra mile even when we are done. So if you haven't seen that presentation, please click on the YouTube video and I will link it below here on Facebook. But the overall point is, what do we do when we are mentally finished? When we are done? You can stick a fork in us, it's over. What do we do when we've made up our mind to start a new chapter and then someone asks us for one more thing? What is your response? Like the carpenter, we can go through the motions and just rush through it, not concerning ourselves with the details or making it the best, greatest thing we've ever done or created. There. So this week we're moving into that as a primary focus. Who are you? Who are you? What is your leadership style? Who trained you? And what is your skill set? So if you're ready, grab your journals, grab your Bibles, and let's dive in. Who are you? What is your leadership style? So whether you are a pastor, minister, Sunday school instructor, or team leader, you have a style. So are you service-driven, meaning you feel responsible and want to serve the people you lead, and that can manifest as connections, resources, opportunities that empower your congregants or teams to make decisions, be radical, and create the same environment for others as they go forward. Being service-driven means you love stepping back and watching what happens as God works through the people entrusted to you. It's radical. That's radical. That's radical. The opposite of that is, are you driven to serve? Meaning your motivation is praise and power. So by truthfully assessing your goal as a feeling or desired impact is crucial to developing a team of like-minded people. If you are someone who enjoys praise and power, you will attract those qualities. Now, while they may seem harmless and ambitious, they can destroy future partnerships with those more discerning. I want you to understand that I'm not trying to change you, but hope and pray that you see that if you have your Bibles, open with me to Matthew chapter 20. And I'm going to read verses 26 and 27, which in the Amplified Bible says, "But Jesus called them to himself and said, 'You know that the rulers of the Gentiles have absolute power and lord it over them, and their great men exercise authority over them. It is not this way among you, but whoever wishes to become great among you shall be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your willing and humble slave.'" Power is infectious. It's a presence, and it's downright addictive. Because who doesn't want people to know who they are, who they're dealing with, and understand the authority in which we walk? But you see, there is a divine balance we must strike when it comes to serving, and that can only be achieved when we desire to do God's will. What is your leadership style? Pray and ask God to help you determine if you are service-driven or driven to serve. Point number two, background and training. So when you are thinking about the professors and theologians you've studied under, ask yourself if you get lost in the sauce. Because wanting to be so Pharisaic that you forget love in the process of presenting the gospel, remember, your training is another opportunity to serve and learn from others. Our third point is character. Are you a listener? Do you have preferences and convictions that hinder growth for others? Do you like to network? And what are your non-negotiators? What are you not settling for? What is that? What are those things? Because that's important. Being able to describe your style, your skills, and personality is so very helpful in ministry, well, in life. So saying you're a person that goes with the flow while micromanaging every single detail creates deception and difficulty. So don't be afraid to lay it out so that others are empowered to do the same. You will be surprised at how leading with honesty can take your church or organization to the next level. I know it's not easy doing a deep dive as far as our self-examination, but I do hope these points will serve as a guide and open the discussion between you and God, you and yourself, you and your team. But don't rush the process. And remember, you're never too old or too young to undergo that self-examination. This year, for me, is all about refined expansion. I want God to continue using the Holy Spirit to guide me, and I want to cooperate with my Lord and Savior so that as the sin comes up to the surface, I can repent so that God can see Jesus reflected in me more, because we're removing the sin. We're pulling it off. We're bringing it to the surface. I want to repent and ask God to help me in that so he can be reflected through everything. So being able to describe your style, skills, and personality is just so, so very helpful. Welcome to the very new Talking on Purpose with Tori, the Internet Show, and you are now engaged in taking action steps. I welcome you to this process. As we start building from the ground up. Yes, it's going to be a challenge. Yes, you may say that I don't know what is Tori talking about. I want to give up. I'm not perfect, but I am a vessel. I have seeds to sprinkle, and I will not lose sight of my purpose within God's grand plan, and I don't want you to either. So commit. Commit to making one small change every day, and let's walk faithfully together, winning souls for Christ. I invite you to visit www.torislaughter.com because I will be releasing very soon a course that will fast track all of the information I plan to share throughout this year. It is a course specifically designed to help you as a church or faith-driven organization. So please visit torislaughter.com and get acquainted with what I offer. Read through my statement of faith and even set up your initial consultation. I look forward to working with you. Thank you for listening and for being here, and I hope that you will share this content with friends, families, enemies, frenemies, whatever, but share. Please let someone else know that you are here and that this content is helpful. So don't forget to check the description underneath via Facebook or YouTube. I will have some helpful links there below, and I look forward to seeing you next week. I think that's all. Oh, and the scriptures. Yes, scriptures will be listed there as well. Okay, that's it. Have a great week, a fantastic weekend, and I will see you next Friday.